In this video, I am going to explain basic anatomy of cranial bones and suture. I am not going to explain every single detail of cranial suture and the bone, but this is going to be very, very important. The first bone is this one, the brown color bone. This is occiput. It's on the back of the head. Occiput. This orange one is temporal bone. There are two temporal bones in the body. This is left temporal. And this is right temporal. Okay, this is on the side part of the cranium. Now, what is this green one? This is parietal bone. Like a temporal bone, parietal bone is paired. There are two parietal bones. Left one, right one. And what is this blue one? This blue one is frontal bone because it's on the front part. And what is this purple one? This is sphenoid. Sphenoid, it's very, very deep bone. You see the part of sphenoid here, but if you look the cranium inside, there is a sphenoid here. This is sphenoid. This is very, very important bone. Okay, let's go back to the review of cranial bones. Now, what is this one? This is occiput. This is temporal bone. This is parietal, frontal bone, and sphenoid. Now, let me explain the suture of cranial bones. What is suture? Suture is joint between cranial bones, like this. It's classified as joint, but it doesn't move a lot, like a temporomandibular joint, like here. It's considered as immovable joint. However, this is my opinion. Since this is classified as joint, I think it moves very, very, very tiny. It doesn't move like the mouth, but I believe it moves like tiny distance. Okay? Now, let me explain the suture. This is coronal suture. It's on the top part and go to the lateral part of the cranium. It's like a crown, right? That's why this is coronal suture. Okay, this is composed by frontal bone and parietal bones. And what is this one? This is sagittal suture. Sagittal suture, it's like Sagittarius, you know? That's why this is kind of the this way, okay? Sagittal suture. It's made by parietal bones. Okay, let's go to the back side. What is this one? This suture is composed by parietal bones and occiput. This is lambdoid suture because this name is from the Greek letter lambda. This shape looks like lambda. That's why this is lambdoid suture. Now let's go to the lateral part. There is suture between temporal bone and parietal bone. This is squamous suture. Squamous is kind of anatomical word for scale. Scale is the kind of skin of fish, right? Because this shape is like scale. So this is squamous suture between temporal bone and parietal bone. Now let's go to the back side again. There's suture between occiput and temporal bone. What is this one? This is occipital temporal suture. Nice, right? Now let's go to the important point in the suture. I just explained this is lambdoid suture, squamous suture, occipital temporal suture. There is a meeting point among these three sutures. This point. This point is called asterion. Asterion is from the star, meaning star kind of a shape, right? This is the meeting point of three sutures. Okay, now let's go to the anterior part. So this is this area. This area is called pterion. What is pterion? Pterion is the meeting place of many suture, this area. So there are five sutures composing pterion. What is it? This is squamous suture. And what is this suture? This is sphenosquamous suture here, by sphenoid and temporal. Okay. This is sphenoparietal suture here. And this is sphenofrontal suture. And what is this one, this part? Is this like a frontoparietal suture? The parietofrontal suture? No, it is not. Do you remember this suture? This is coronal suture. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sutures. Pterion is known as the weakest point among the skull. If somebody got head trauma here, boom, there is high risk for hemorrhage. So this is very important place. The review of pterion. Squamous suture. Sphenosquamous suture. Sphenoparietal suture. Sphenofrontal suture. And this is coronal suture. Very, very important place. You know, suture is very important for kind of the hands-on technique, manual therapy. This affects so much for headache, tight head, and so many other things. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of cranial bones and suture. Okay, so I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.